Hi, I'm Rob, and today I'd like to show you a few featherboards, homemade, especially for job site tables. And this is done especially for the DeWalt table saws. And those table saws, they come with a problem. The blade, the tabletop, is very compressed. So it's all quite near to each other. And sometimes if you buy those featherboards, they don't fit. So I thought, well, it's during this corona period very difficult to get parts. And import, that's only in here in Holland for maybe one or two times a year. And if it's gone, it's gone. And then you have to wait an enormous time. So I thought, well, let's make it myself and see what comes out of it. And it was a success, and that's what I like to show you. Well, I think it's a great system, and I don't have any complaints. It works perfectly well. Well, here you see the mounting system. It's not with T-bolts, because they are very hard to get in Holland. So I did it with a carriage bolt. You know, I ground it off, and then this one is I think 45 mil. But if you grind it off, it will fit into it, in the T-track, no problem. And a fat washer, 10, I think 3/8 for you people. Washer, and the knob. You see, that's a fine system. Works. Works perfect. Well, the problem with this kind of job site table saws, you have a very small table space in front of your blade. And it is in this case 7.5 inch. So that's not a lot. The slots, they pass the fingers, or the feathers, how you want to call it. I did that, so if I bring it all the way to the maximum, I can pass wood in here on the free side of 5.25, and that's it. Because yeah, with job site tables, it's all very near to the blade. So I thought, well, I make one myself, and I did it then MDF 3/4. It's 3/4 thick. MDF, you see, and the angle is around 65. Those teeth, maybe you can see it like this, they have quite an flexibility, but I think this is the right compromise. If it's pure MDF, it has a very nice friction. It works incredibly well. I was very pleased with it. I still am. I did a lot of these teeth, different, and a different angle, different thickness. And then I came to the conclusion that this was the first one I made, but it was also the best one. So I keep on using this one. Well, this is then the backside of the resaw fence. And the backside of the featherboard. And I did it with some knobs. You see, metric 10. That's in English, I think, 3/8. And I placed them on the backside. So the carriage bolt is quite flat on the working side. Now, this is then the front of the resaw fence with the featherboard. And here you have then the
carriage boards, so it's quite a flat system. I like it.
Well, here you see almost similar boards, only this one has a little bit of a bigger gap between the teeth. It doesn't matter much, and the teeth are in a way a bit more fat, but it works equally the same. So you can do it very neat and you can do it not so neat. The working for this one and for that one is exactly the same. Well, here you see then a different material, and this is polyethylene. Those are cutting boards. They are a little bit too thin in a way, because they want to flex a bit. And if you keep it a bit closer to the attachment point, so you make a pressure plate, yeah, it's over. But it's not bad, you can see. It moves. It's very hard to make it move if you want. You know, you can put a lot of tension on it. You see different types of fingers. These are a little bit smaller but with wider gaps. These are a bit fatter with lesser gaps. You see in between. But they work equally well. And if you have thin stock, then I think if you have two plates of 3/4 in here, it starts to be a bit cramped. And this is then half an inch. It goes fine. It really goes good. So if you have a very thin stock what you have to cut and you work near the blade, then such a finer blade, you know, like this, is maybe a lot better. But also the teeth are on 65 degrees. And in my case they are 10 mil, I think 3/8 of an inch width. And also the same length then. The length is the same. Yeah, it's 2 1/4. 2 1/4 inch. So, you can do it also like this. Well, I hope it was a clear video. And yeah, maybe I gave you people some ideas that you think, oh well, that's usable. And maybe you can use that for yourself in the future, for your own project, I don't know. But anyway, I'd like to thank you for watching, and maybe till the next time. Bye bye!